This is a short video showcasing some of the recent changes and updates to Pobal Maps. To access Pobal Maps, type in the URL maps.pobal.ie or click on any of the links in www.pobal.ie to access Pobal Maps. If this is your first time accessing, you may encounter this message. Please proceed to install Microsoft Silverlight, as this is a standard internet plugin and will allow the smoothest experience in using the Pobal mapping system. The data sets that have been added to the Pobal Maps in this recent update include 2011 census data by age cohort, so 0 to 4 years, 5 to 9, 10 to 14, 15 to 8, and two additional data sets, persons with a disability and households without a car. They are available at small area and ED level. One of the other additions in this version of Pobal Maps is the ability to do analysis using this age data by ED and by small area. Currently you can see that the tools are grayed out. Once I zoom in, those tools become active to me. So I now have the ability to do some analysis by ED and by small area. Before I start doing that, I'm going to turn on my ED boundaries. A simple way to do that is at the filter here at the bottom of my layer list is to type in elect, and it gives me all of the data sets that have those search terms in them. So this is the one I'm interested in, electoral division, in the boundaries dataset folder. So that layer is now turned on for me. So I'm now going to look at my age data by ED. By clicking on the relevant EDs, I can see in the left hand side the data is aggregating up. I have a pie chart here at the top and I have a stacked chart at the bottom, giving me the information about those particular EDs that I'm clicking on. I can add a maximum of 10 EDs to my chart. Down the bottom, it gives me the data for those individual EDs. As I hover on them, they're also highlighted in the map, and I can expand that to look at the individual numbers within that particular ED. I can also access that same data by hovering over the charts here and also here to get the total. So I can see that in the EDs that I've selected, there's 160 15 to 18 year olds, and that represents 26.23%. When you're finished doing your analysis, click clear and you can start again, or you can do the same analysis by small area. This data has also been made available when creating reports. There's a couple of options for creating reports across the different geographies that are displayed here. I'm going to look at EDs. So you'll see it's still grayed out for me, but once I zoom in, it becomes available to me by clicking on ED. And as I hover over, it selects and highlights the current ED that will form part of my report. So I'm going to choose Kilmurry, Clunadrum, Mullagh, and Anna. So I've selected those four EDs. If I wanted to select more, I could continue on selecting different EDs through this interface here. Let's just add one more. Once I'm happy with the EDs that I've selected, I click Run Report and it'll prepare a report. This report is generated live, so as the data is updated, you'll get the most up-to-date data through this report. So I have a report already created. I've selected, in this case, three small areas. It gives you a synopsis of the map, and then across the bottom tabs, the information contained within those small areas. So the first one was county data, so it's County Clare and all of the associated data. ED, so I've selected three small areas that are all within the ED Doonbeg. So I can see the total population, and as I scroll to the right, I can look at the age data, and I can actually look at it in this case by individual years, so 4, 5-year-olds, 6-year-olds, etc., all the way up to 85 plus year olds. Same, it gives me the list of the townlands and the small areas. This is the area that I selected on. So I've selected three small areas and I have all the associated data with them. So I can now tell that within the three small areas I selected, there are four 16-year-olds as per the 2011 census data, and so on. And I can scroll through the different tabs along the bottom. So that gives you a very quick overview of some of the changes that have been made. There's plenty of other functionality within this mapping system, so I encourage everyone to explore and to look at the other tutorial videos that are available. Thank you very much.